Previously on The Real World.
For Nepal, our job is to make 6 REI commercial spots.
We've got a new show on 107.7 The End. I'm Lindsay.
If you sound prepared on the radio, you don't sound good.
You never know with Irene right now if she's going to blow up or if she's going to be cranky.
This is the true story.
Of 7 people.
Picked to live on a pier.
Work together.
Have their lives taped.
To find out what happens.
When people stop being polite.
Start getting real.
The Real World.
Seattle.
Bye-bye. I'll be back. Bye, guys. Bye. It's
gonna find out about... right now?
I'm gonna get tan. I do.
You're a chalk woman.
I am.
All right. I'll massage you when you get back. I promise.
Do you give massages too, Steven?
Huh?
You give massages too?
Irene is like, she lives her entire life as like this comic strip. So that's exactly what she lives as. She's a comic strip girl.
If Steven cooks too, I will marry him. I just want to have a husband that cooks, cleans. So do you cook for real? I'm gonna have to marry you now. I'm serious. You can have affairs on the side. I don't care about that. That's the other thing. I just want my dinner and clean sheets.
In other words, you want a bitch.
That's right. Basically.
Irene, we've kind of connected cosmic energy in the last couple weeks.
Hey, baby.
Sorry, guys.
Where you come from, Kent?
Yes.
I kind of left my heart in Nepal. I mean, I love the place. I can't wait to cut the REI spots, because that's going to be really fun. Did you bring the tapes?
Like, notes and stuff.
CDs?
Oh, come on, man. You're kidding, right?
No, I'm dead serious, because I didn't see them when I left.
Would Nate have them?
Well, they're in the house.
They're for sure in the house.
Yeah, they're totally in the house. What's up, bud? Nah. Have you seen the REI CDs?
No.
Yeah! It was right next to the nudie book. Hey, man.
Later.
I'll see you later. There was a mad dash for him, and I was like, they have to be put up somewhere. Where would I put them where they're safe? And I know the girls won't get to them and lose them. They're right next to the boys' porno on the bottom row. So it's actually something to play these?
Yeah, it's just perfect.
Cool.
What these CDs have in them are sound bites and sound effects. Kind of using it like a daily journal, like day 2 on our REI adventure in Nepal.
You and Lindsay are both people that like prepare a lot and write things down. You can sound natural, like written down. You guys are real preparers. Like you write things out.
We need to now for the first few shows.
Right. But I don't work that way. Not funny telling a joke 30,000 times over. You guys prepare the way you prepare to feel comfortable for you. Because they're such preparers, I know that I was saying some funny things. They were not listening.
Okay, just think of it with anything I say. When I tell a story, it's better the first time it comes out of my mouth.
Irene, she likes to be funny, and she's gonna do her best to make sure that people think she's funny and that everybody knows exactly how funny she is.
Like, I never, like, wrote things out fully. I'd always be like, da-da-da-da, you know?
We ran into a lot of problems with we'd say something spontaneous and we didn't have enough time. Irene's funny. Her personality's been so on and off lately. I really don't know where the hell she's coming from.
Ew, October 4th, 1992. I still remember. Where do you see the bar in 5 years? Do you still see it being the crocodile in the corner, still doing what it's doing today? Yeah.
It's been going on for a while now. I've been sick.
Do you want to intro this one? Anybody want to? Specifically?
It's not like I need to be in bed, per se. So it's very hard to find a balance right now. Why don't you get in your PJs and you want anything? Glass of water? Coffee?
Yeah, maybe.
Oh, I think I'm gonna puke.
Go lay down.
You know when you have those headaches and you like can't see light?
Yeah.
Oh my gosh. Man, I don't know what happens when I get these headaches.
You never got checked out before?
Well, I only had one, like, once.
It never occurred to you once to go to the doctor before it?
Well, it was only that one headache. And this is only the second time it's ever happened. Well, like, this year. Man, I'm trying to think, like, if there's any patterns. I can't even say. No, it's over my left eye.
Here?
Yeah.
Does the pressure feel good? It does or it doesn't?
It does.
Saying 107.7 The End, Friday is the Sub Pop 10th anniversary.
My head is on fire.
I know the aspirin isn't helping, huh?
No. I've never been a person that had headaches before, and I've been getting wretched headaches.
Maybe you should read the concert calendar. No, I won't. You do it.
I don't read things well.
You picked your songs.
Like, I'm saying I'd rather you do it.
No, at least for tonight.
Sasha, what's wrong? Are you gonna feel me?
Oh.
You to do it.
No, I know. That's why I was looking over.
That's why.
I thought you wanted me to do it.
No, just to be sure.
That's why I was like,
tell me exactly what you want. She has a headache again. She goes to work, gets angry because she doesn't want anybody at work to know she's sick. I don't know. I just don't know how I'm supposed to feel.
You don't think we're being inconsiderate and like just not listening enough and not?
No, I don't.
I just want to make sure that I'm not being like, whatever the word is, uncompassionate or whatever.
We don't get impatient with each other, you know what I mean? We know really we've got something going on.
I just feel like maybe there's something I'm missing.
I think we're missing our past, though. You know what I mean?
Namaste, welcome to Nepal.
Celebrate the year of Nepal and find out about 50 other exciting trips with REI Adventures, a worldwide travel company.
The REI spots are coming along fine. I'm doing the intros for the girls' commercials.
I want this to be like a, like we talked about, like a trip journal. I mean, everybody knows it's a commercial. Are you awake? But, yeah.
Basically, Kelsey's done everything for us. We're having one problem after another.
I'm going to email my script to you tonight. Is that cool?
Yeah, because that's what I was going to say. I want a written script.
For being a bunch of overachievers, we're taking things pretty slow.
Do you guys have any scripts ready tonight?
And even this.
I'll email them to,
Yeah. At REI.
At REI.com.
Be ready to
All right,
people.
Love you.
Oh, my God. I just feel like such an old lady.
Why don't you lay down? Here, you should lay down.
But my arms have been falling asleep a lot more lately.
I think she just wanted some sympathy for a while, but maybe she is really sick. And I do care. I told her if she is sick, I'm there for her, and so are all the rest of us.
Like, I've been bruising. I have bruises all over my body. I've never had that before. I mean, I don't know. It's like, this thing is so frustrating, because every time I feel like I get over something, I get something new. This is not something I want to be going through right now, you know what I mean? And I don't want to be talking about it, analyzing it. I don't want to have my arms fall asleep, and I don't want to be sick right now.
I slept next to her that night, saw if she needed anything or not. Put a blankie on her, gave her a little ugly dog that she sleeps with. And I don't know how she's feeling. She didn't say anything to anyone, so everyone was in the dark.
What happened?
Steven was supposed to fax her his script by 8 this morning.
He didn't fax her yet? He's right over there. Should we go talk to him?
Steven would do a good job at it, but he dropped the ball. He was supposed to have his script done, and he didn't do it. Steven, did you check your email today?
At all.
Because Kelsey, did you talk to her at all?
No.
Now talk to her when you get there, because I don't think she was too happy when she called me today.
Because I had to turn it in today.
I'm just being real, you know what I'm saying? I got a lot of boo-boo.
I understand you got
So I'm wiping my butt up right now.
I just got my deadlines too, yeah. So you should have called.
You know I'm like slightly the... I was just out doing my thing.
I know.
My
I waited all day for your email. You should have at least called.
I didn't, but see, the thing is I slept the day. I woke up at like 3.
Rebecca, she said she thought I was terminally messy. I live in fear that's the truth, that perhaps I am terminally messy. I do have a fear that, I mean, it's not like I'm just like organizationally challenged. If I'm gonna be neat, that's all I can do. That's all I can do. I mean, I just follow this abyss of cleaning all the time.
She's just really strange. Like, she went on and on and on. How she doesn't want to be a messy person. How she needs to clean up. And I knew it wasn't about cleaning up. I knew there was something more to it. And I didn't know if it was about cleaning up her life or her needing to just feel, like, stable.
I feel like this is what happened. I got very interested in listening to people. I haven't been fully honest with that.
Irene, she like declared this epiphany.
I think you need to go back to Nordstrom's. That's what I think you should do. I think you should return. You don't need those pants.
And she says to me, you know, you're worried about being financially responsible. Well, then that's just it. Go return your stuff to Nordstrom.
And I think that's it. Like, I feel so much better having told you that.
Don't come in here and start screaming, man.
No, I'm not gonna scream at you. I'm so happy.
Did you give me drugs?
No. What happened was,
this girl is just up and down, up and down. She's like a roller coaster right now.
I'm telling you, Nathan. I'm telling you, like, straight up, with that dream you had with me, with the testicles, this is what I think of it.
Oh my God!
What I think of it.
She started talking about my dream and trying to interpret my dream, which don't do.
I just never told you, but this is what I think of it. I think it absolutely has something to do with, like, where I stand. Like, maybe it's hard for you to have a woman with a voice, or you have gay tendencies. That's what I think.
I have no idea what kind of medication Irene's on. Whatever it is, it's called bitch.
Okay. See, I'd rather that. I'd rather you be offended by what I say. I think that's it.
It's weird. I don't know the full story. I really don't know if I've seen the real Irene because I've seen so many different Irenes.
Well, I'm like this. I often do this. I haven't done this since I've been here, but this is how I think. I think out loud and I think rapidly.
That's just confusing. And I guess once we find out what's exactly going on, we'll know exactly how to react to it.
An afternoon safari aboard an elephant provides a great viewing point for spotting a bathing rhinoceros, and later, a jungle walk with our guides yields a rare view of the endangered Gario crocodiles and alpacas.
Want to give them a ride for REI because I'm really, really grateful to REI and to Rusty and REI Adventures for sending us on this trip.
And later, a jungle walk with our guides yields a rare view of the endangered Gariel crocodiles and wild peacocks. Am I all done?
That was good.
Excellent.
Yeah! Rock and roll!
Yeah, tell Nathan that.
I'll see you later.
There are people that walk around with medical problems all the time that you just don't know about.
Like, I took my medicine every night and I regulated myself, but I was a person that walked around with this that nobody really knew about. Now it's different and my body's demanding. And I do have to go public because, I mean, my body's making me. It's very hard because it's been 3 years that I've been sick with this Lyme disease. You get it from a tick, and I'm not better.
I feel like a chump because I feel like we haven't taken, like, anything seriously enough as far as, like, your migraines and, like, your bruises and all that stuff go, and, like, I feel like we could have done more to help you.
Sickness is very hard for anyone to understand. I got diagnosed with Lyme disease right before my sophomore year of college. I had no concept of what Lyme disease was. It's so hard because, like, I'm so, like, torn. On one angle, I'm, like, real psyched that I've gotten this far. But on another, I'm just like, am I ever going to get better? Like, am I going to live my life like this? Oh, my God. I mean, I have bruises all over my body. Oh, I just miss not being, like, I miss being healthy. Oh, my God.
I can't believe you've been going through this alone. It's best 2 months.
I don't know what's wrong with me. It's so stupid, I know.
Well, it's not.
Why don't we go call a doctor now? Do you want to get the paper?
Yeah, that's what I have to do.
I need Dr. Mara because I was referred to her. I have Lyme disease.
And I'm very scared about going to the doctor because I know they're going to tell me something's wrong with me.
Maybe it's just a little bit of a relapse.
It's a bad situation in the sense that I never took proper time off. And, like, if I'm having, like, a relapse,
Irene is getting a relapse of Lyme disease. After I looked it up on the internet, it is a lot more serious than I thought. A lot of it causes fatigue, nausea, muscle weakening, abdominal pain. It's a nightmare.
The funniest thing is how I fill it out. Like, that's why I need a friend in life to come with me. You see how, like, I like to live my life in denial.
Very often, 10% of adults with it can be fatal. 40 to 60% experience major muscle deterioration that can never be fixed.
Hi, how are you?
Okay, why don't you have a seat there? I'm okay. Staying over before, and that's my chair, actually.
Oh,
so we'll put you
in. Appreciate that girl more than anything for going to the doctor with me. I really do. Lately, I've been getting, like, these terrible headaches, which was never really a symptom of mine before. My hands and feet fall asleep all the time. And the other thing is, I'm finding, like, I'll do something little, like, bang into this a little bit, and I'll get, like, a huge bruise. I know I've been sick this whole time, and I know I didn't know I was sick. That's why Lyme disease is the disease in disguise. Like, my bigger fear was that there was nothing wrong
crazy.
With me. Instead, she tells me, oh, no, you have neuropathy.
Neuropathy. Well, at least, you know, at least you know you're not going nuts.
I find out I'm sick, and it makes everything make sense. It makes all my behavior make sense. It makes, like, my confusion make sense.
I just have nerve damage. At least I'm not going insane.
How sick is this? I'm so happy that there's something wrong with me.
What do you mean they're damaged? Like, what, you don't have any feeling?
My feet are asleep right now. Well, I guess, like, I was getting...
Wake up, you dog!
Get up! Feet, get up! I think I have nerve damage, too.
You don't have nerve damage.
I love Irene. Irene's like my sister. Now, the more I'm learning about this Lyme disease, it's a sad thing. Like, there's no cure. It's horrible.
I'm trying to be as non-serious about it as I can. But the truth is, it is serious.
Hello?
Hey, Mama.
What up, Jay?
Are you sick, man?
Yeah.
I mean, because I thought I'd be out of line if I raised Ben in front of Rebecca or anyone else.
Ben.
What's going on?
Dude, I'm pretty sick.
People with Lyme disease actually develop peripheral neuropathy.
You never said anything about it. You would always blow it off like it was nothing.
Irene's one of those people that isn't going to totally advertise that she's sick, but she wants to be normal. She wants to be Irene.
It happens to people that have, like, AIDS, too. You can get it from certain things.
It's kind of like a slap in the face. You're like, listen, sis, if you don't ship up your act, you got to ship out. You're going to die.
Are you going to be all right? You don't know.
I don't know.
On the next Real World.
Being sick is a real quick way of finding out who's going to be your friend and who's not.
Irene's relapse is isolating her from everybody in the house.
More than half of the house. They simply don't like her.
You're my... Listen, that's a bad thing.
You see a whole nother side to her, and it's not a pleasant side.
And it leads to a momentous decision.
I mean, can you die? You can die from Lyme disease, can't you?
You don't die from Lyme disease, but, like, say I had caught a cold, I would have gotten pneumonia like that.
I went to the hospital, and the doctor, he's like, we're going to check you for mono, and we're going to do a Lyme test, but we think you're pregnant.
You think you were pregnant at the time?
Yes, I thought I was pregnant.
Did
the doctor tell you you're pregnant? You think you're pregnant? It's pretty funny, because I'm a virgin. I thought I swear to you, I was married. I was like, oh my God, Jesus is inside of Irene. That is what I was thinking. And like to this day, that's pretty much a very funny joke for all my friends.